Is this a pathway to citizenship for these young people?
Not at all. In fact, that's where Congress needs to act. And we continue to urge the Congress, you know, pass the DREAM Act, look at comprehensive immigration reform, the immigration system as a whole. I mean, I've been dealing with immigration enforcement for 20 years, and the plain fact of the matter is that the law that we're working under doesn't match the economic needs of the country today and the law enforcement needs of the country today. But as someone who is charged with enforcing the immigration system, we're setting good, strong, sensible priorities. And again, these young people really are not the individuals that the immigration removal process was designed to focus upon.
What about the parents of these children? The children come forward now. They identify themselves. Should the parents be concerned that potentially they could be deported? They would now be identified as illegal immigrants.
No, we are not going to do that. We have internally set it up so that the parents are not referred for immigration enforcement if the young person comes in for deferred action. However, the parents are not qualified for deferred action. This is for the young people who meet the criteria that we've set forth.
What social services would these young people be qualified for? Would they be qualified to receive Medicaid benefits, food stamps, school vouchers, stuff like that?
No, they won't be. Again, there is deferred action now given in certain cases, and they don't qualify for those type of benefits. The one thing they may qualify for is a work authorization card if they can demonstrate economic necessity.